Fucking hell, Kareem Jackson. You know, I didn't even see that comment that you said about enhancement drugs, you know. But yeah, I think was it the Russians or something like that? They got banned from the Olympics. I'm sure they got removed from the Taekwondo Olympics because obviously I'm a Taekwondo practitioner, so obviously I follow Taekwondo. Yeah? I'm sure the Russians got removed from the Taekwondo Olympics, if not all events, because of doping. Yeah? Bro, I don't want to turn it into this right now, yeah. But if you take drugs to enhance your performance, yeah, you're a cheater, yeah. You're trying to go the easy route. You don't want to put in all the amounts of work to win. You're a cheater. I would never do. I would not feel right as a man. Yeah. I would not feel like a winner if I'd done performance enhancement drugs to win. Yeah. Yeah, I'm lifting the cup, yeah, the gold cup, whatever in it, yeah, like first place, yeah. But when I look in the mirror at night time, I have to think to myself, like, you're not really a winner. You're a loser, you're a cheat. You took drugs so that you could win. You're not a real winner. A real winner don't need drugs. A real winner, he just does it. If you're a real winner, you just drink Lucozade or water. Yeah, you don't need no drugs. Yeah, if you're a real winner, you can start off behind. Yeah, you can start off in a losing position, yeah, and still win. You don't need no drugs to win. I would never take. I don't even know what these performance enhancement drugs are called, but I would never take any of these kind of drugs. Yeah? Back to what I was gonna say anyway. So there's certain people, man. They do drugs because they need it as like a coping mechanism, whatever, innit? Yeah. I know people, right? Family members have passed away or whatever, and now they bun weed, yeah. And their excuse for bunning weed is, oh, my family members died or whatever, innit? Yeah. So, the weed is you're taking my mind. No, that is not the solution. Yeah? Yes, you are mourning. Yes, you are upset. Yes, it is a hurtful experience to go through a family member passing away. But doing the drugs is not going to bring them back. Doing the drugs is only going to do more harm than good. The people them that are doing drugs to cope with, the stress of a family member passing away, yeah, would that family member want you to do drugs? The answer is no. So why are you doing it? Why are you? Nothing good is going to come from bunning weed. Yeah, you become lazy. Yeah, you're not 100%. Yeah, you're wasting money on things you don't need. This is probably why people don't have no money to fucking buy a property. Yeah, because all their money goes on drugs, and drugs are not cheap. Yeah? Drugs are not cheap. Drugs are expensive. They make you feel good. So something that makes you feel good, you're gonna want to have it all the time. And if it's expensive, you're gonna be flinging money at that. Yeah, flinging money at that. What, a man bones weed every day? Yeah, he might pick up an eighth. Yeah, nah, I can't even remember how much. I don't even know how much an eighth costs. I know how much an eighth weighs, but I wouldn't even know how much an eighth costs nowadays, isn't it? Yeah, but I think what back in the day, eighths was £20, £25 or whatever, isn't it? Yeah, man might smoke two of those a day. Yeah, or at least one a day. Yeah, that's £20 a day. Yeah, that's six bills a month. Yeah, it's an expensive habit to have. It's an expensive habit to have. It's why people can't afford to buy a property or nothing like that, because six bills of their money is going on drugs. And they will lie and they will tell people, I ain't got no money because of this, because of that. Yeah, they won't tell you, oh, I've just slang six bills at drugs, Like every month, my drug intake costs me six bills. I know, man. Normal man, black brother, Young guy, same age as me, yeah. Well, a year above me in school, but same age as me basically, innit? Yeah, didn't go to my school, but man, knowing from the local area, normal, healthy guy, yeah, normal guy, not no, yeah, funky youth or nothing like that, normal guy, yeah. Unfortunately, one of his family members passed away, innit? Yeah, the youth is a crackhead now, yeah, he's actually on drugs, Like, he hangs around with man that I know. Were crackheads from 10 years ago or whatever, innit? Yeah, he's rolling with them, man. And one thing as well, yeah, You see how I said that my man was a normal you or whatever, innit? Yeah. You see a lot of these older men that you see on the street, like if you're from the ends, like AY London, he's from the ends, innit? He's from Sydenham or Lewisham, wherever, innit? Yeah. So that's to me, I don't know Sydenham, but I know Lewisham is ends, innit? Yeah. Certain of them man that you see AY London, yeah, that are crackers, like older black man, yeah. So man might be 45, 50 years old or whatever, innit? Yeah. Believe you me, them man there were like top boys in the ends back in the day. Yeah? I know a man, right? My stepfather said to me that when he was younger, he used to see this particular person we're talking about. Yeah. He used to see him back in the ends. Yeah. Like my stepfather, not from Edmund, but anyway, yeah. He used to see him back in the ends and he used to not look up to man like, oh yeah, top boy or whatever. Innit? But yeah, he was an older man in the ends and had a local reputation, whatever. Innit? So yeah, you could say he was looking up to man, whatever. Innit? Now he just looks down on man because now he's a crackhead. Now I didn't know that. Because I just see him as a druggie or whatever, innit? But back in the day, them man there, yeah, them man had a name. Certain man that I'm probably flexing with will probably be crackheads maybe in 20 years' time. It happens. Because what happens is these men offend, yeah, they commit crimes and shit, they go to jail, they get 4 or 5 years in jail, yeah? So not 4 years, do two. I mean, like, they might get a 10-year stretch and then do 5 years or whatever, innit? Yeah? Them man are stressed, them man start doing drugs in jail. Yeah. Man are starting doing drugs in jail. And remember, a lot of these men that are like 45 years old, 50 years old or whatever, innit, yeah? They're from the 80s, yeah? And that's when crack was like weed back in the 80s, apparently, innit, yeah? I ain't gonna think no names, but there's certain people that I know as well, yeah? They were on crack as well, innit, yeah? And they're from that era or whatever, innit, yeah? And they've been on crack from when they was 20 years old, because back then, smoking crack was like burning weed, yeah. Even for black people,